Hi, I'm Ladidi, and this made me feel 7 years old again.
I went on a mission to see the impact of RAM on gaming performance on APUs, and for the specific test, I used the 8700G. A lot of people were actually waiting for this video, so now it's out. But before I get too ahead of myself, I need to thank Kingston, Corsair, Gigabyte, Razer, and AMD for helping me make this video possible. To further expand on the reason for this video is that APUs have gained massive traction and RAM has played a crucial or significant role in this. For example, the speeds of the RAM that we see in handhelds, and I'll do this in descending order. Just a forenote, there are varying versions of handhelds and CPU types, but I just want you to understand the trend. The first one was the original Steam Deck that started at 5,500 megatransfers. Next is the Steam Deck OLED at 6,400 megatransfers, the original ROG Ally at 6,400 megatransfers, the Legion Go at 6,400 to 7,500 megatransfers, the Ally X at 7,500 megatransfers, and lastly, the Steam Deck 2 rumored at 8,533 megatransfers. Most of these handhelds use either the Z1 or Z1 Extreme APU. Note that the Steam Deck uses something a little bit different or custom that they had custom made from AMD, but the Z1 Extreme has 12 RDNA 3 compute units. Coincidentally, this is the same as the 8700G with Radeon 780M, which also has 12 cores on RDNA 3. As we know, the 8700G APU was designed to be a gateway or entry-level APU to be able to game, but oddly, it had a max supported RAM of 5,200 megatransfers, which made no sense to me because of what we saw on the handhelds. Now, from the data that we can look at, the RDNA 3 structure or architecture loves fast RAM, so I decided to see how much it loved fast RAM. The premise for these tests was to see the viability of the 8700G as an everyday gaming APU, so I tested this at three different speeds. Firstly, at 4,800 megatransfers or standard, next at 6,400 megatransfers overclocked, and lastly, 7,400 megatransfers overclocked. Note, I pushed for 8,000, but the fastest speed that I could achieve on the 8700G was 7,400, and I promise I tried everything, but 7,400 was stable, and I didn't get any blue screens after I did mem test. But before we run into the test, it's important to go over the specs of the build. The CPU, or rather APU, was obviously, as mentioned, the 8700G. The motherboard was the Gigabyte Aorus Ultra B650i. This was the Revision 1 board. RAM was a Kingston Fury Kit, 32 gigs at 1616 at 8,000 megatransfers. The SSD was a Kingston Fury Renegade, 1 terabyte. The PSU was the Corsair SF850L 80 watt gold. There was no GPU, obviously, except for the one built into the APU. The cooler was the standard cooler that comes with the 8700G. And the case was the Corsair 2000D. For enjoyment purposes, I wanted to keep this in the realm of affordability, in which I got some peripherals from Razer, and the peripherals that they sent me were the keyboard being an Ornata V3X, the headset was a Black Shark V2X, and the mouse was the Razer Cobra. But let's see what actually happened during testing. The games that I charted for this was Age of Empires 4, Counter-Strike 2, Formula 1 2021, Hitman Absolution, and Left 4 Dead. I'll show you the settings per game as we go through them, but the main thing is that I wanted to make it enjoyable at 1080p, which I achieved in everything except for Age of Empires 4, which could be subjective, but for me, it was more like Minecraft. But let's go through it. Before we go into the games, I just wanted to do a quick 3D Mark times by benchmark so that we could see from a benchmark perspective what the difference would be. And it hit a score of 3078 at 4,800 megatransfers, 3,638% at 6,400 megatransfers, which is an 18% increase on 4,800. And lastly, at 7,400, we hit 3,825, which is a 24.27% increase on 4,800 megatransfers. Starting off with Age of Empires 4. Here are all the settings for the game. Obviously, this wasn't set too high, as Age of Empires 4 can be quite demanding. Now let's start off with 4800 megatransfers. The average frames per second was 148, so we do have a lot of bandwidth there to up the settings, especially if you're used to playing at 60p. But on the average percentile, we hit 72. At 6400 megatransfers, we hit 168 on average FPS, and the 99th percentile was 83. Then up to 7400 megatransfers, where we hit 173 on average, so not a massive increase on 64, and the average percentile increasing by 1 to 84. Next we have CS2, and now we can run through the settings. Starting off with 4800 megatransfers, average of 58 and 99th percentile of 45. Booting it up to 6400 had a massive impact, taking it to 76 on average, and the 99th percentile, 57. Then lastly, a small gain on 7400, hitting 78 on average and 59 on 99th percentile. Formula One 2021, the settings. Formula One 2021, on 4800, we hit 117 average FPS and 91 on the 99th percentile. 6400, not too much of an increase there, oddly enough, but 120 average FPS and 92 on 99th percentile. But then we saw an anomaly in a massive increase to 139. Well, not so massive, but definitely on the chart, a bigger increase, 139 average FPS, and the 99th percentile at 109. Next is Hitman Absolution, which played fantastically. Let's look at the settings. Starting off with 4800 megatransfers, we hit an average of 87 and a 99th percentile of 59. Booting it up to 6400, we had an increase to 107 with a 99th percentile of 69, and then no increase on FPS of 107, but we did see an increase on stability on 99th percentile of 75. And last but not least, Left 4 Dead, the game settings. Now this was one of the oddest results, because it's pretty much mirrored from 4800 to 7400 on the average FPS, basically being 178, 179, and 180. We did see a big increase to the 99th percentile, going from 118 to 169 at 6400, and then an increase of 1 to 170, noting that 6400 would be the best for this game. Now I'm going to put a table up in front of you to show what the gains were from 48 to 64, 48 to 74, and 64 to 74. You can go through this at your leisure, but I'm going to look at overall, in which from 48 to 64, we saw a 14.13% increase on actual frames and 99th percentile of 20.64. So a lot more stability, small amount of increased frames, but big increase on stability. Then from 48 to 74, we saw an increase of 18.86% average FPS and a massive increase of 27.75 on 99th percentile. And lastly, 64 to 74, we saw an average increase of FPS of 4.4 and 99th percentile of 6.5. In conclusion, we didn't just see better FPS, we saw more stable FPS at the 99th percentile, making gaming not only better, but more enjoyable overall. But at this stage, I wouldn't recommend anything over 6400 megatransfers, as the spend wouldn't warrant the return. To give you an indication of how good it is, I actually use it now at my home as my main, call it home PC gaming build. Again, a massive thanks to Kingston, Corsair, Gigabyte, Razer, and AMD for helping make this video possible. I hope you enjoyed this and enjoyed the results. Look forward to seeing you on the next one. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Cheers, guys. Goodbye.